Okay, in this video we're going to simplify the rational expressions, the fractions, and then we'll divide the polynomials by a monomial. So we'll do this example 1, then example 2. So please write down example 1. It's x plus 3 all squared plus x minus 3 times x plus 3 all over 2x. Okay. So the trick with this is to simplify the top somewhere else and then divide by 2x. Okay, so we're going to write out this over here, x plus 3 all squared. By the way, if there's a squared on a parenthesis, it means parenthesis times parenthesis. Okay, so it's got to be x plus 3 times x plus 3, not x squared plus 9, that's wrong. Got to write down x plus 3 times x plus 3 because it's more complicated than just x squared plus 9. Okay, and then plus x minus 3 times x plus 3. So what we're doing is we're writing out the top of the fraction, and we're going to simplify this on the side of the page, and then we're going to go back and rewrite the fraction again. And so we're going to, whatever we get here when we're done simplifying, we're going to put that on the top of the fraction and then divide by 2x. Does that make sense? So we're going to simplify over here, put it over here, and then keep going. So it's a long problem, but you have all the skills, and I'm kind of excited about this because I think it'd be good practice for you anyway, because we have the skills to do all this. So let's multiply this guy out. X times x, right? And then x times 3. So x times x, x squared, x times 3, 3x, right? And then 3 times x, and then 3 times 3. 3 times x, 3x, 3 times 3, 9. Plus 9, sorry. Okay. So now we'll do the x, do this guy over here. So x times x, and then x times 3, right? So x times x is x squared, but we must go plus. We must go plus x squared, okay? And then x times 3 plus 3x. 3 times x minus 3x, and then, or negative 3 times x is minus 3x, and negative 3 times positive 3 is minus 9, okay? So just take your time, there's no rush. But if we add like terms, okay, if we add like terms, I mean, we can here just add the x squareds right away, right? X squared and x squared, what does that make? So it's 1x squared plus 1x squared. How many x squareds do we have? So that's 2x squared, isn't it? Right? And then if you add the x's, right, you've got 3x plus 3x, that's 6x, right? But we've got 3x minus 3x here. What does that make? What's 3x minus 3x? See, this is 0x, or 0, right? If you take this 3x plus 3x, that makes 6x. So we have 6x and 0x, which is just 6x altogether, okay? And then if you look at the numbers, we've got 9 and minus 9. What does 9 and minus 9 make? That makes 0, right? So you can put down 0, but at the end, it's just 2x squared plus 6x. That's the whole top of the fraction, right? So this entire top of the fraction multiplies out, and it just gives you 2x squared plus 6x. Okay? All divided by 2x. So we're dividing the polynomial by a monomial. All of this divided by 2x, which means we need to divide this guy by 2x and also divide this other guy by 2x. Divide both terms by 2x. So we need to divide the 6x by 2x as well as the 2x squared, which I'm going to write 2xx. Okay? And they're separated by a plus sign. So I'll simplify each one of the fractions and we have our answer. 2 into 2 goes once. X and x goes once. So that gives us 1 times 1 times x over 1, which is x over 1, or just x, plus 2 into 2 goes once, 2 into 6 goes 3 times, 2 into 2, x and x goes once here and here, So that's 3 times 1, which is 3 over 1 times 1. So it's 3 over 1, right, which is 3. So x plus 3 is our answer, right? So just for what great practice of all the skills we've learned recently, or lots of them anyway. Why don't you write this example out? Please press pause on the video and do it all yourself. You'll probably make a mistake because it's a long problem, so don't be disheartened and don't be too hard on yourself. But it's good to try these things by yourself and then watch the video, because that's how you learn, oh, maybe I should have written that a little neater, or I forgot my negative here, or whatever. So it's good to make a mistake on this and then watch the video and fix your mistake. So by all means, press pause, go ahead and try it, do the best you can, and then check the video, and hopefully you'll learn something. Okay, I hope you press pause and tried it. I'm going to do it now, just in case you need help with it. So it's all squared, x minus 7 all squared. So that's x minus 7 times x minus 7. Okay, and then we have plus x plus 7 times x minus 7. Okay, so x times x squared, x times negative 7 minus 7x, right? And then we have negative 7 times x minus 7x again, negative 7 times negative 7 plus 49. Oops. Okay, now to multiply the other binomial, let me just get some more paper here. So we're going to go x times x, x squared. Now don't forget your plus sign. So you got a plus there. Plus x times x, x squared, x times negative 7 minus 7x. 7 times x plus 7x. 7 times negative 7 minus 49. Now when we put the terms together, we've got an x squared here and an x squared here. That's 1x squared here, 1x squared here. Put those guys together, how many x squares do we have? 2x squared, right? We have, if you look at your x terms, the nice thing is if you look over here, that's a minus 7x plus 7x, okay? So these two guys combine to give 0x, or 0, right? So that means we just have to think about the negative 7x minus 7x over here. If I'm in debt by $7 and I subtract $7, I'll be in debt by more, right? Minus 14x, in debt by $14. You can change the subtract sign to plus negative if you like, because now it says negative 7x plus negative 7x. That's negative 14x, okay? So we have all that taken care of. We just have to take care of the numbers now. We have a plus 49 and a minus 49. What do they make together? See, they make 0, right? So you can write down plus 0 if you want, but you don't need to, because the answer is 2x squared minus 14x. So all of the top of the fraction became 2x squared minus 14x, right? So we go back to the fraction and we write the top became 2x squared minus 14x, and that's all over 2x. So now we need to divide the polynomial by the monomial, right? Press pause and continue if you want to do it from here. Okay, I'll do it now. So we divide everything by 2x. We divide this guy by 2x. We divide this guy by 2x, right? So 2x squared is 2xx. 14x, okay? 2 into 2 goes once here and here. X into x goes once here and here. So we have 1 times 1 times x over 1, which is x minus 2 into 2 goes once, 2 into 14, 7 times. X into x goes once, x into x goes once. So 7 times 1 over 1 times 1 is 7 over 1, which is 7. So we have x minus 7 is the final answer.
Okay.